Hi, and welcome to today's video, how to create and use viewports. We'll go over some of the basic types of viewports and how to edit them once you've created them. To insert a single viewport, navigate to the Sheet tab and select the command from the Viewports panel. From here, you can simply insert your rectangular viewport in your sheet space. Other command options are available in the same dropdown, so let's insert a polygonal viewport. This allows us to create a viewport that has multiple vertices and midpoints. This new viewport behaves similarly to a polyline and can be adjusted as such. Now let's convert an entity into a viewport by using the Entity option. First, we'll insert a circle into sheet space. Once we have our entity, we run our Entity Viewport command and select our new circle. The entity is then converted to a viewport, and these circular viewports are commonly used in detailing. Let's run a print preview on our new sheet space and see how these viewports appear in our PDF conversion. Here we can see that our viewports are printed like any other line would be, but this can be adjusted. To hide viewport lines when printing, make sure to put them on the Def Points layer, or any layer that is not set to print. I use the Def Point layer because it is impossible to set a layer named Def Points to appear when printed. Now you can see our viewport lines do not appear when we preview our print. We can adjust the scale of our viewports individually to display different levels of detail for each viewport. Select the viewport you'd like to adjust and change the scale using the Annotation option on the status bar. Cycle through multiple scales until you've selected the correct one. Adjust the geometry being displayed in your viewport by double-clicking inside of it to activate the selected viewport. Click and hold your mouse wheel and drag your cursor to pan and adjust your viewport until you're satisfied with the positioning. Double-click outside of your activated viewport to deactivate it and come back to sheet space. To lock your viewport scale and position, select the viewport and make sure that the display locked property is equal to yes. Now we cannot adjust the scale or position of the viewport. You can trim an existing viewport into a new size and shape by using the viewport clip command. First, insert an entity that's going to be your new viewport. Run the viewport clip command. Select your viewport that you'd like to alter, then select the entity that you'd like to be your new viewport. To learn more, visit DraftSight.com.